Happy Friday, everybody. Sports Guy Chris checking back in with everybody out there. And of course, yesterday I got my official March Madness 2020 bracket simulation going for the first round. We had the first half of the first round games go down yesterday. And I'm back today giving you the results for the second half of those games, the next 16 that has dwindled us down to 32 games. And guys, what a day it was. The simulation is having some fun for us. I'm excited to give you these results. If this was our real March Madness, I think all of us would really, really be appreciating this and really enjoying it. So anywho, with that being said, here are the results. One note on the simulation, I'm just doing one. That's it. You know, March Madness is just a one and done thing. You play one game. It's not, you know, 100 times or 10,000 times and, you know, you take the majority of who wins. It's a one-time thing. So the simulation, having a little fun with us. It's throwing some upsets in there and everything. But that's what I'm doing, just one simulation. Whatever it gives us, it gives us. If it was all chalk, it's all chalk. If it was crazy upsets, it was crazy upsets. So let's jump into it today. I've got the results for the second half of the first round. In the first game of the day, was an 8-9 matchup between Providence and USC. The Friars jumped out to a 7-point halftime lead, but they blew it down the stretch. They lose 67-65 to USC. So my Friars couldn't get it done, unfortunately. They stumble. USC rallies in the second half down the stretch to win by two. They move on in a great game to start things off right away in day two. The second game was a 3-14 matchup between Kentucky and Hofstra. Kentucky pulled it out. The Wildcats won 77-69. They moved on. The third game of the day was maybe the best, or certainly one of the best for sure. It was a 5-12 matchup in the West region between the Ohio State Buckeyes and the 28-3 Stephen F. Austin Lumberjacks. The Buckeyes outscored the Lumberjacks 44-34 in the second half to rally back. They hit the game winner with a second left to win it by a single point, 77-76. So Ohio State survived, you know, avoided the upset, and they moved on to the second round. And again, one of the games of the day, really. So an exciting 5-12 matchup there. The next game provided the biggest upset of the tournament to that point. It was a 3-14 matchup. Again, in the West region, Villanova taking on Boston University, and Boston U rallied in the second half, outscored the Wildcats by 8 to force overtime, and then got it done 83-79 in overtime. So Boston U, the 14 seed, big upset over Villanova as they move on. The next game was another 2 seed with the Duke Blue Devils down in the East region taking on North Dakota State. They rallied with a big second half, 45-23. They outscored the Bison in the second half to move on and win the game 79-63. The next game was another 5-12 matchup, this time in the Midwest region between BYU and play-in game winner Cincinnati. The Cougars pulled it out. The Metrics, of course, loved BYU this year. They get it done. They beat Cincinnati 74-64 in a game that they pretty much controlled the whole way. So the next game of the day was a 6-11 matchup between Illinois and Liberty. I think many, including myself, would really like the Flames' chances going into this one. Liberty with 30-4 season, regular season and conference tournament champion there out of their league. But alas, Illinois came to play today, guys. A Fighting Illini blow out Liberty 72-51. Illinois advances the 6th seed, so nice win for them. They move on. And the next game of the day was another 4-13 matchup here. Maryland and Belmont going at it in the South region. And another big upset. Belmont, the Bruins, rallied with a 39-28 second half to beat Maryland 73-66. Definitely not rigged. I picked Maryland to go to the Final Four out of this bracket, guys. So the Terrapins wiped out. Belmont moves on with the big upset. So that whole region, a lot of upsets going on. So the next game of the day was a 7-10 matchup between Houston and Oklahoma. The Cougars moved on as the 7th seed, 65-58 in that one. And then the next game, another big upset. We go back to the South region. It happened in that region again. The 2 seed Michigan State taking on the 15 seed Winthrop, and Winthrop got it done in a tight game the entire way. The Eagles pulled it out 70-66. Of course, Just a couple years ago, Michigan State was also upset in the first round as a 2 seed, this time by Middle Tennessee State that time. This time it's Winthrop. The simulation having some fun with us. Big upset there. The next game of the day, another Big Ten team, my Wisconsin Badgers. Oh, I hope they avoided an upset. They were taking on Northern Kentucky, and they did. The Badgers, with a great defensive performance, they pulled away from Northern Kentucky and won rather easily, 70-42. So Wisconsin takes care of business with a great defensive performance. The next game, 7-10 matchup, another Big Ten team, Penn State, the 7 seed, East Tennessee State, the 10. And the Nittany Lions rallied. They erased a 7-point halftime deficit to beat East Tennessee State, who again was a popular upset pick going into the tournament. I would have picked them to win that game, but Penn State gets it done. The next one was our final 5-12 matchup, and in this one it was Indiana playing game winner taking on West Virginia, and the Hoosiers came to play. They blow out the Mountaineers 86-66, one of the surprising results, I think, the point spread. Maybe not necessarily Indiana wins, but wow, they wallop West Virginia, and the 12-seed Indiana again in the South region moves on, so tons of upsets down there. Our next game was Auburn and Arizona State in a great 6-11 matchup. Arizona State pulled that one out 72-67. Again, a game that was close the whole way. Dayton was the next team and the final 1 seed in action, taking on Eastern Washington. They won 77-61. Relative ease, they pulled away in the second half, you know, to make it a 16-point win. And then the final game of the first round was the biggest blowout of them all. Oregon, the 4 seed, was taking on the 13-seed New Mexico State in the West. Oregon completely blows out the Aggies 91-51 to move on to take on Ohio State, what should be a great second round matchup. Crazy upsets, guys. The South region, how about this? The 12-seed Indiana wins, 13-seed Belmont wins, 11-seed UCLA wins, 10-seed Utah State, and 15-seed Winthrop all won in advance in that region. So the simulation having some fun with us, guys. That is the end of the first round. I will be doing the second round simulations tomorrow afternoon. I'll be back with those, taking us to the Sweet 16. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and follow me. Find me on Instagram and Scorem. Very happy Friday out there. Stay safe, stay strong, everybody, and stay positive. At Sports Guy Chris, I'll be back again tomorrow. Have a great one.